I've been an executive recruiter and owner of a recruiting agency for over 20 years. And through that, just been able to really touch the lives of people and organizations throughout the country. And we work also on global situations too, so outside the borders of the United States.
Okay.
But along with that, has been a drive and a passion to make a difference for people. That's really what I'm all about. And so, in a way of giving back, in many ways, I created a website called Directional Motivation Large Focus Audrey. It's based on the returning veterans, transitioning veterans coming back into society. And there's a huge need there. So what we've done is dedicated a large portion of our site for that transition.
Tell us, Russ, about the books that you've written and why you believe they are different from the other works that have been published. What's the difference there?
Sure. Well, I have two books right now. One is called How to Get a Raise, the correct way to ask for an increase in salary and wages. And then I have another book that's published right now. We just finished the final editing of it, so we're going to go to publication very shortly.
Great.
And that one is how to interview what employers want to hear in today's competitive job market.
The veteran community. Tell us about your efforts there and how you actually got involved there.
I was working with a Fortune 500 client, and they asked me in the recruiting that I do, and I do a ton of work for them.
Mm-hmm.
And they said, you know, if you run across veterans, let us know about veterans, you know, because we love hiring veterans. I said, really? Your private sector employers are looking for the really good, soft people feel in the
right
environment. Well, surprise, surprise, veterans have it, but they're not communicating on the same level. That veteran that left the house and walked out the door on deployment is not the same person as the individual left. When they come back, they're different. Their experiences have been different. They've seen things that are almost, you know, from the out of perspective, things that would just have to blow your mind. A lot of people don't realize that chaplains have a tremendous amount of resources at their fingertips, in addition to spiritual.
Okay.
They have connections with agencies all over that can provide the help and that type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And what's unfortunate is a lot of our veterans have been trained to be very, very self-sufficient. I can do this on my own. Everything is on my shoulders, I'll carry the weight, that type of thing. And for a lot of our veterans, they wear that badge, like a badge of honor, that they can be self-sufficient, they can get through this. The problem is mentally, physically, emotionally, they're not geared to battle on the whole front.